Let's start off our demo by taking a look at how we might create a dictionary. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off by setting this up as an empty dictionary right here. And now I can go in and start populating it with whatever it is that I might want. So I can say person, and then first equals Christopher. And then I could say person last, and then set that equal to Harrison. And I could also just do this in one line. So let's actually do it this way. By the way, cool little Visual Studio trick. Highlight an item, Control-D, Control-D, and that will select all of them. And then I could change them all in one shot. So I could actually then just call this Christopher, just like that. Cool. So now let's put in Susan's here. So let's say Susan. And let's just do this all in one shot. So we'll just go ahead and say first, and we'll set that to be Susan. And then we'll say last, and we'll set that to be IVAC, just like that. Cool. So now, if I go in and I say print Christopher, and I say print Susan, now what you're going to notice is that it will print out both of those items there. So there's Christopher, and there is Susan. Now, just because I have decided to put both of these inside of dictionaries doesn't mean that I'm precluded from putting them inside of a list, which is kind of cool. So I could actually say presenters, or people maybe, equals create a list, and then we'll say Christopher, and we'll say Susan. And so now, if I print out my people, and we'll just put in a closing print down at the bottom there. Let me make sure that little bit of IntelliSense goes away. Go away. Thank you. There we go. That way you can see the code a little bit better. Now what you're going to notice is it prints out Christopher and it prints out Susan inside of that one list. And that gives me the opportunity to really drive home the point that when you're working with a list, you can actually store any type of item that you might want inside of there, including dictionaries. And you'll also notice that I'm using a dictionary much in the exact same way that I would use an object. Kind of a very similar bit of functionality there. I could also go in and add in somebody. So let's just do this. Let's just go ahead and say people.add, append. Sorry, there we go. That was what I was looking for. And let's say first Bill, and then last, and we'll say Gates. There we go. And now let's go ahead and run that. And now you'll notice that we've added Bill Gates to the very end there. And if I want to go grab our presenters, just like we had before, now I could go ahead and say our presenters. And let's set that to be people. And in my case, again, going to start at zero. Going to grab two items. And now let's print out our presenters. There we go. Going to put all of the code onto one screen so that way you can see that. And now, when I run this, it gives me my people up at the very top. You'll notice the full list. And then when I print my presenters, now you're going to notice down there towards the bottom, it's just Christopher and just Susan there. Because again, we restricted that list to just the range. I also want to highlight here that when I do this, when I go in and I say people 0:2, I get that range, it does not modify that list. It creates or returns a brand new one. Last little thing, let me just go in and comment this. I want to highlight this one more time. I know I had it on the slide, but it bears repeating here. And let's just say presenters, and let's rerun my code. The way that you get a length of a list is by calling that len function. This is one of those that always throws me, because in a lot of other languages, it's typically a property. So you would typically say the name of the list or the name of the array dot length or dot count, and that would give you the value back. In Python, you call that len function and pass that into there. So in that demo, and in this whole section, We saw how we could use lists. We talked a bit about arrays. We saw dictionaries, and actually how we could bring all of them together.